Puerto de Mogan Vile apartment. We were here back in 2012, so it's 5 p.m. We've arrived just in time to check in, unpack, and go for dinner. Pretty hungry. This is our view. So we're heading out for dinner for our first night. We're just walking down into the little village and we're just gonna choose a restaurant. We don't know which one yet, but we're gonna book in for dinner early tomorrow night, which is one of our favourite restaurants here. It's amazing. They keep making the wood burning stoves, so we'll show you all that tomorrow anyway. It's a lovely walk into the marina. It's about a 10-minute walk from the hotel. So it's really lovely and it's like a nice breeze and everything tonight. So it's lovely. Beautiful evening for a stroll.
Not bad, is it?
Just back from a little supermarket shop to get some food for the next week, just for like breakfast and lunch, because we're going to be eating out every evening. So, water, beer, huge grapes, one little apple, or one big apple, crisps, coconut yogurt. Lovely bread, milk, orange juice, cheese and ham, and cured meats for sandwiches, and then some tea. We're just walking about today and taking in everything that Puerto de Mogan has to offer, and it's absolutely gorgeous, and we just come across this amazing landscape. Lunchtime at the hotel. You haven't had pizza yet?
Nope. This is a good looking one.
Mmm. Oh! Oh, they went in that one.
Bad mother.
What's your language? Puerto de Mogan, and the music really sounds like they're on the I'll shine. Walked up this really steep hill. Gonna check out what's up here. Dinner time, and we're thinking a nice Italian would be nice tonight. We're in the mood for some pasta. It's a beautiful evening here in the sun, the setting is gorgeous. So the Italian restaurant that we wanted to go to is Felipe, so we picked that for Sunday night, which will be our final dinner, and then we come to Cafe de Mogan for dinner tonight. We've been threatening to go here for so long, and then finally we did, but it's a crappy view. Oh la la! Tuck in. It's not big enough?
Nope.
Well, I'm just up. It's morning time here in Mogan, and I'm going to be walking into town shortly to get a mani and pedi done. And I'm just having breakfast before I head into town. Just got coconut yogurt, granola, chopped banana, grapes, and fresh strawberries, a cup of tea, some water, and I might do some social media as well while I'm having my breakfast. just off the submarine ride, and it lasted 45 minutes, and we got the bimini. Mm-hmm. It was good fun, and then we got some souvenir photos. Good height difference there. So it's our last full day on holiday, and we had a nice sleep in. We had a leisurely breakfast, and now we're just gonna go for a little dander. We're gonna see if we can maybe get some back massages done. We might play a bit of pool, but I think we'll just do a lot of reading and relaxing on our last day before we go back home tomorrow. So far it's been an absolutely brilliant Babymoon. We're enjoying just time, quality time, the two of us, before baby decides to arrive in August or September, we don't know. So it's been lovely, and it's been nice to come back somewhere where we've been before, and we know, you know, the location, and we know what stuff we want to do and all that sort of thing. But it's also been great exploring new bits of the island as well. So yeah, and I'll show you before I go, I will show you my mani and pedi that I got yesterday. I was really pleased with it. I got gel nail polish. I think this is called, this is Essie Glamping Not Camping. So it's like a really deep, rich coral colour. And something similar on my feet. May have done a bit of shopping. I may have bought two items. You shouldn't have brought me here.
My fault, isn't it?
Just enjoying our last morning on holiday, on the balcony, having a lovely croissant and some tea. So yeah, we're going home today, very sad, but it's been an amazing Babymoon. We've really enjoyed ourselves, and we look forward to coming back to Gran Canaria in a few years' time.